is what it's all about. We've been on this BIM journey for a number of years now, and along with CETA and Alan and the team. And I suppose it's about 2 years ago now, Alan, I think, since we were invited to get involved in BIM Regis, and we were delighted to do that. I think by the time we had left that breakfast series meeting that morning, I think we had a committee set up, I know, for in terms of the West, and people were, you know, such was the enthusiasm and to get involved and to get this thing set up. What is it? It's a voluntary initiative. It's people working together. To add value to what we're all trying to do. That's fine, yeah. So in Ireland, we have a number of regions, north, south, east, and west, and I suppose we have some subdivisions of that in terms of the Midlands and so on and so forth. Really, we don't want to talk of them as regions or silos, because it's about working together on a local, regional, national, international level. We spoke together and we've attended events, Killeen and myself and others here in the room today, over in the UK, about what we're doing here in Ireland. And we talked yesterday about the importance of working together in terms of educating, sharing knowledge, mentoring, and providing opportunities at a local level for graduates coming through. That's really what the regions is about for us. I'm very fortunate in the West, where I am, that we have a college, GMIT, that opened the doors, and that's our hub in the West of Ireland. And similarly, right through Dublin and Cork, up in the north, up in Sligo, similar things are going on. So in terms of the website that was launched last week, BIMregions.ie, it's an extension, really, of what has been happening on the ground. And it really is about providing an opportunity for people to come along, present at events, and even students that need practice in getting up there in front of groups like this for maybe the first time, presenting a paper that they might have written before they go into an employer. All of that type of thing is what we are trying to promote. Killeen is going to walk you through the website, and hopefully we can take some more learnings from there.
No problem.
Thanks, Mark. So I would have been involved with the BIM regions the last 12 months with a co-chair along with Joe Walwork from CBRE. So part of the initial goals that we tried to set up with the BIM regions and the steering group in the Eastern region was to have collaboration with all the regions based in Ireland, to have a central location for information, training, awareness, documentation, and to have a central place for people to go for all the information if we're talking to clients, suppliers, subcontractors in the one environment. So the idea to promote the website and to build the website was the primary goal for the region. So really, what will the website provide to industry? And the big part of it is that it's a central location for all information in terms of your standards. Your standards, information, documentation, it'll give you information on your events. And just, it's very small, I should come over here to the screen, can't see on that screen. So we're just saying with the BIM regions, I'll just go back here one slide, sorry. So the main thing is the events, so the regional calendar, in terms of any events, the likes of the BIM gathering, the CIF, any industry events that will be held throughout the year, we have the regional calendar that all the events throughout the industry will be promoted through this website. The next thing then, we're seeing the blog, which is going to be a big part of the website for the third level of education. Part of the BIM regions, we're going to be going across the different universities, so each region, I'll be on the Eastern region, but all the different steering group members will be presenting across the third level education and promoting the blog. Blog will essentially be a location to put up a topic of a thesis and get industry feedback and share this on social media through LinkedIn, Twitter, and essentially for students to get industry feedback. And then if there's a topic that a contractor or subcontractor is having issues with or wants some kind of feedback from industry, this location to post a blog on an industry problem and they get industry feedback on it. So the blog is probably going to be the main thing that's going to drive the website. The next part of it then is promoting the actual the regions within Ireland. And you can see that on the map how the different regions are split up. Within each one of the regions, you can see the steering group members and who is the points of contact for the steering group members of each region. So this area, the steering group members would meet on an ongoing basis, and this is really to get set the goals, targets of what the steering group would like to achieve throughout the year, and what topics we're going to discuss throughout the year. So that's really, it's a web-based platform, so you can access through mobile, desktop, and again, the www.bimregions.ie, so you can, if you can check it out and give your feedback on the website. So CETA will be the administration for the website in terms of updating content. So the way the website would work, we then have everything BIM, so there's a tab then that you have in terms of what the BIM regions are about. BIM case studies, so we're working with the BICP in terms of case studies that have been released across the industry. So really this is different case studies or different projects that have been delivered in the Irish industry. In terms of if someone wants to know what, how do you deliver a BIM Level 2 project, there's case studies on a delivery of a BIM Level 2 project, there's case studies on people just starting off with BIM. So there's a number of different case studies that the BICP have been promoting, and this is a central location to raise that awareness. Then the next thing, as I mentioned before, the events, and that's your industry calendar for all events through CETA, through CAF, CAOB, your industry events will be promoted on this calendar. BIM articles work in a partnership with Irish Building magazine, and then in terms of articles that be published through the industry, this here is the location where you get those articles. With the BIM training and support, we've connected with BSI, the BRE, and CETA SkillsNet in terms of location for training that's provided through industry. So if you're talking to clients, subcontractors, suppliers, of where they need to go to get training, direct them to the website and to have the training for all your needs on the website. The next thing really would be the resources and guidance. So the resources and guidance would be your standards. If you're on a project and there's people referring to PAS 1182 or BS 1182, we have all the standards located within the website, and they're all viewable on the website. So even if you're on, in a client meeting and there was a certain part of the website that you had to review, you can review this or go to your BIM resources and guidance documents, have all your standards there, and any standard that you have to refer to, you can allocate it quite quickly, you can download it, and you can view it online. The next part would be the, this is just your standards, and I said that's the BS 1182. And the next part is probably the biggest part to get the biggest kind of promotion of the website for the BIM regions. So Fred Mills from the B1M would be the director of and founder of the B1M, which is the large construction industry videos across globally. So it's the website has really taken off. So we spoke to Fred Mills in terms of partnering up with Fred Mills to raise the BIM awareness. So there's a lot of good video content within the B1M website, so we partnered up with Fred Mills to raise the awareness. So there's a lot of good videos in terms of explaining what BIM is and what to get out of a model. So BIM for beginners, you click on your BIM awareness and it'll direct you straight to the B1M website. So Fred was more than happy to partner up with the BIM regions, and this here's something that we can probably direct people to in terms of if they're trying to figure out if a 40 is a topic that's coming up in conversation on the site. You can direct them to the BIM regions website. And all the awareness is there. There's a drop down of different videos for people who need to get the awareness really on the website. And then, so the next part really is who built the website. So, as I mentioned at the start, the BIM regions would have led in the development of the website along with CETA. So, it was actually Barry McGawley that we had a conversation in terms of what we want to get out of the website. So, really, we wrote down a script in terms of how the website was going to be built. And then the development team within CETA actually supported us to develop the website. And we've probably been in 6 months testing of just developing the website, testing out different issues. And it was kind of a beta format in the steering group. And we got a lot of feedback from the group. what to change, what to update, where the different links go to, how to improve the website. And so we've launched it last Friday. The exact stats to date, I know last week we're up on 2,000 views of the website, and that was on the launch of it. So we're just, I haven't got the stats just today, but it was 2,000 within the launch of the website. So it's getting a lot of traction, and it's kind of industry, this is where we want industry to go for information, to get your awareness, to get your training. It has all the industry standards there, and that all the BIM regions are promoting the one message across the industry. That's really where we're trying to drive the website to, that, and then the students will drive this here through the blog. So if there's any students that have a topic on BIM or digital technology in construction, that they're posting that topic on the BIM Regions website and are getting industry feedback from it. So who would be involved in running it? CETA is the administration of the website, so CETA is going to support us in terms of delivering the website. So any suggestions coming back in terms of if there's an issue or if there was a link going to the wrong information, or you had some feedback that you wanted updated, if there's a link within the website, the email, and it goes to CETA administration, it'll be registered as BIM Regions, so the steering group will get the information, and then CETA administration team would update the website with all topics to really update the website and keep it current. So it's a live website and it'll be updated constantly. And that's really on terms of the updates. So why did the BIM Regions need a website? We needed a website because what we found through the different regions, the regional events, and the same topic could have been coming up in different regions, but it was being described in a different way, or it wasn't a clear message going out. So really what we're trying to do from the website is deliver a clear message to the industry. If we're talking about PAS Level 2 or delivering BIM Level 2 process, that it's the same process in Dublin as it is in Cork or as it in Galway, and similar in the UK, that we were delivering the one message, because in the industry there's probably a different opinions and different discussions in terms of how it should be delivered. So really to have this website as a central location to raise the awareness and to give a clear message to industry was really the goal of the website. So our message really to across the industry is to really use the website as a platform for all your information, for all your training, for if you're talking to a client and your client is, but I don't really understand PAS Level 2, you can quickly have it on your phone, on your iPad, go to the website, you have all your standards there, and then there's a lot of videos there. You can just direct them to the website, the client can take it with them, go through the website themselves, and get up to speed through the B1M, through the standards, and the website is really a way to promote BIM awareness across the industry. A central location for all the students really to, as they get the industry feedback on their topics. And look, I'd just like to, I suppose, thank Mark and the different regions for the, I suppose, the collaboration in terms of the building the website and the work that we were doing together on it. And so again, it's just www.bimregions.ie. So thanks very much, and more than happy to take any questions.